Ladies and gentlemen, the organist entertains. And a big hello from your old organ grinder friend, Robin Richmond. Well, we're delighted to have on the show tonight three big names in the theatre organ world, Miss Ina Barger, Sydney Gustard, and Reginald Porter-Brown. Also, young Brian Sharp, truly one of our finest electronic wizards. Opening honours then to our charming lady organist, Miss Ina Barger, playing the Granada Harrow Wurlitzer, and a little piece called Dancing Bells. Ina Barger at the Harrow Granada Wurlitzer, an organ, incidentally, that manager, Mr. Mendelssohn, features fairly regularly at public performances. Well, now, I don't think we've had a Gulbranson electronic on the show before, so here's the Gulbranson Paragon in the capable hands and feet of Brian Sharp. Thank you. Spanish Eyes, played by Brian Sharp on a good Branson Paragon home plug-in. And there again, you see, once again, you can play a beautiful bass line with your feet if only you will try. Now, the dexterous Mr. Reginald Porter-Brown has long and happy ties with Southampton, and it's a great pleasure for me to present him now on the organ he loves so well, the magnificent four-manual Guildhall Southampton Compton. In his inimitable style, and playing the horseshoe theatre console, here's Reg, Marching in the Saints. Saints. So from one great organ name, Reg Porter-Brown, to another, Sydney Gustard. A little while ago, I recorded this splendid veteran pedal pusher at the Compton organ, now immaculately installed in the gymnasium of the Taverham Hall School near Norwich. We'll be talking to two of the schoolmasters and to Sydney Gustard in a moment, but first, here's the maestro playing Birdsong at Eventide.
Thank you.
Sydney Gustard playing the Taverham Hall School Compton. Taverham, sorry, not Tavernum. I must have taverns on the brain. And here are the two masters who masterminded this excellent venture. Well, Robin Wilson, you and your younger counterpart, Stuart Orr, are responsible for putting this organ in. Where did it come from originally?
It came from the ABC in Harrogate. We took it out, brought it down and put it up, all with our own two hands and the aid of a few boys in the school.
What first gave you the idea to have an organ in the school?
Well, the main thing was the acoustics of the building it's in. It's in our big gymnasium theatre, which has got such fabulous acoustics that we always thought an organ would sound marvellous. If we could get one, where could one find an organ that wasn't going to cost a fortune?
And Stuart, from your point of view, had you studied the workings of organs before?
No, I'd first got in touch with these instruments through David Shepherd, with whom I was at college.
And another schoolmaster.
Another schoolmaster, yes indeed. And he asked me to come along and record him with my tape recorder at an organ which happened to be in a cinema. And I hardly believed him at first. I didn't know these things existed. But after this, I was thoroughly converted and have been interested in the cinema organ and everything to do with it ever since.
The amazing thing is that neither of you are the music master, because you teach what subject?
I teach modern languages and Stuart teaches science.
Science, yes.
Right. Are any of the boys learning the organ here?
Yes, a few of them can play the organ a bit. We've got another organ in the school, actually, another one we built ourselves, which they use for that sort of thing chiefly. But this organ is allowed as a treat for the boy who can play well, is allowed to fling on the Compton just now and then.
You were telling me over lunch, Robin, that there are, I don't know, how many organs here in Norfolk?
There are eight cinema organs in Norfolk now. There were only three in the days when organs existed in cinemas, but Norfolk seems to have become something of a sort of retiring ground for old cinema organs. And we've got now three Wurlitzers and five Comptons in the county.
So here once again is Sydney Gustard playing the Taverham Compton and a composition of his own aptly named At the Console. Sydney, when did you start?
The back end of 1919. I'd come out of the army in February, went back to my old office job, but I just couldn't stick it. And an advertisement appeared in the local paper at Newcastle, where I lived then, asking for an assistant organist at the new pavilion. And I applied for the job, and to my great surprise, I was offered the job, assistant to Harry Davidson, was the solo organist there.
What was the make of the organ, do you remember?
Oh, a perfectly straight organ. I think it was Blackett and Howden.
Of course, you really made your name at Chester.
Yes, dear old Chester.
How many broadcasts did you do from there?
Somewhere about 200, I suppose, 200 or 300.
And of course, then I remember you must have the distinction of being the only cinema organist who used to come out of the wall instead of going up and down.
Oh, that was after the last war at Camden Town. Yeah.
You used to come out from the side.
That's right. On a sort of little miniature railway, and we pressed a button inside. The whole of the console shook. You heaved a silent prayer that the thing would stop when we got to the end of the railway line, otherwise we might have finished up in the stalls.
Well, you certainly haven't lost the magic of your touch. I think that's it's quite amazing. Can I ask you a really personal question, Sydney? I'm sure they'd all like to know, because to me, you look so wonderfully fit and healthy. How old are you?
78 and a half.
Well, I think that's marvellous. And long may you play, and thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Robin. A great joy for me to be playing again.
Well, we shall be hearing more from Sydney Gustard on future programmes, but right now, Brian Sharp on Hammond T200 with a Lennon and McCartney number, here, there and everywhere. Thank you. sharp. Here, there and everywhere. Delightfully styled, I think. Well, now, it's quite a specialised art, the adaption of light music not originally written for the organ, and Ina Barger is really expert in this field. Once again, then, at the Granada Harrow Wurlitzer, here is Ina to play a little excerpt from the Faust ballet music. Ina Barger with a delightful little snippet from the Faust ballet music. Well, now Christmas seems to be coming in the shops already. So we end once again on a veritable tour de force from Reginald Porter-Brown at the Southampton Guildhall organ. Written by American Garth Edmondson, here is the festive piece, Von Himmel Hoch, or to give it its English title, From Heaven Above to Earth I Come. And with that bravura performance by Reginald Porter-Brown from Southampton and von Himmelhoch, we end our show for today. Forthcoming events this week in the organ world: on Saturday next, the 27th, at 11:30 a.m, there's a public concert on the fine Wurlitzer organ in the State Kilburn here in London, given by David Hamilton. Well, our next Sunday, 28th of November, at 11 a.m. at the Odeon Manchester, Ernest Broadbent and Enid Powell and Michael Sedgwick are giving a concert there for the Lancastrian Theatre Organ Trust. And incidentally, John Potter's in the studio today. Good luck to you, John, with your activities with the Trust. And watch your Gerald Shaw, who's also smiling at me through the glass. 2:30 p.m, Hubert Selby next Sunday is at the Central Hall, Duncombe Street in Grimsby, for the North Lincolnshire Theatre Organ Preservation Society. And finally, last but not least, at 3 p.m, George Blackmore is playing at the Abingdon Abbey Hall. Well, that's about the lot from me, your old organ grinder, Robin Richmond. So till our next merry meeting, same time next week. Bye-bye, everyone.